Treksperts would like to begin today by acknowledging the traditional custodians of the land on which we record. We pay our respects to their elders past and present and extend that respect to Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islanders listening to us today.
You're listening to BQN. Assimilate the audio.
Welcome back, dear listeners, to yet another round of the Treksperts Quiz, a BQN podcast. This is the Star Trek-inspired trivia podcast where each week we put two self-proclaimed Star Trek experts, or Treksperts, into a head-to-head battle for nerd supremacy in order to bring glory to themselves and their houses. I am your host, Davey Willett. I go by he, him pronouns, and it is my pleasure to have you joining me on this court-martial of our contestants' Star Trek knowledge. A big shout-out before we begin to all of our fabulous BQN patrons, especially a big thank you to this show's associate producers, the fabulous Matt Harker and Jason Anderson. Thank you all so much for your support, and don't forget that you can help to keep the Treksperts Quiz coming to you week after week, and all the other BQN shows as well, by signing up to become a patron at patreon.com/BQN. Before we meet our two Treksperts for today, it is my great pleasure to welcome back another former contestant, and a former winner at that. She rolls with she, her pronouns. She brought glory to her house in our strange new quiz. You know and love her from the Strange New Pod. It is the amazing Giraffe. Giraffe, welcome back to the quiz.
Thank you for having me. I feel so like warm, powerful, seeing all the questions, knowing the theme.
I sensed you were a little overwhelmed leading up to today's recording. You were like, Davey, this is so much power. What do I do with all this?
With great power comes great responsibility.
I know. I've never seen you so composed, actually. So clearly you're taking this role very, very seriously.
Absolutely. Wait until I mess up the math.
There's a spreadsheet there that should hopefully do it all for you, but we'll see. So what have you been up to since we last caught up? You were on the show a month or two ago. What's been happening?
Not much. I've been working a lot and traveling, so I've been a little bit MIA. But I had the opportunity to go to a Star Trek tour in Ticonderoga, and that was amazing. Ah. So I think that's the only Star Trek thing I've been up to. And very soon I'll be at WonderCon on a Star Trek panel, so it's coming
soon. Oh, on an actual panel? That's exciting.
On an actual one, yes.
There we go. We've got convention royalty on the pod today, everyone. Well, let's meet our Treksperts then, because they are in for quite a wild ride today. So I'm going to activate the transporter. We're going to energize, and beam in our first contestant. Our first Trekspert is a fellow BQN host with she, her pronouns, who loves TNG, DS9, and the Lower Decks. Host of Infinite Diversity and History with the Szilagis, it is the wonderfully smart and gorgeous Chrissie D. Szilagi. Welcome, Chrissie, for the first time to the quiz.
Thank you so much for having me. I have been wanting to do this since I listened to the first episode, so.
You've had a bit of a warm-up. Yeah, you've had a bit of a warm-up. We've been chatting in our BQN host chat, and you're like, Davey, where's my invite? Is it time yet?
Oh, no. I hadn't reached out to you yet. No, listeners, don't think that. I had not reached out to him yet. I was waiting for the semester to be over because I kept getting grading and more grading and then more grading. So, yeah.
It can take a bit of psyching up, and definitely, yeah, our real lives, they complicate our podcasting lives sometimes, that's for sure.
Yeah.
So you told me that you have actually been doing really well listening along to the show at home. So how confident are you?
I shouldn't have told you that, but okay.
Yeah, I know. So how is that confidence translating now that you're actually here in our center seat?
I'm gonna do honor to my house.
Yeah. Exactly. That's all we can ask. Yeah.
You know, and worst place scenario, I'm second. So it works either way.
That's a really glass half full kind of attitude. We like that here on the Treksperts Quiz. We like a bit of positivity. All right. Well, we have got a fabulous contestant for you today, a competitor who we're bringing in now. I'm just going to engage the transporter again. Our second Trekspert is a lover of Deep Space Nine and a Trekspert on all things Kelvin timeline, which is something I haven't seen yet. Very interesting. A fellow strange new pod host, a fellow strange new pod host, along with Giraffe, beaming in with she, her pronouns. It is the fabulous Emcee. Welcome for the first time to the quiz, my darling.
Thank you for having me.
I loved reading your questionnaire, especially the part where you said you spend way too much time on memory alpha. And I can tell you, same. Same. And that you write Star Trek fan fiction.
I do.
Very cool. I'd love to hear a little bit more about that. What's your genre of fan fiction?
Unsurprisingly, Kelvinverse. I'm currently working on a fairly epic piece, which is Michael and Spock growing up in the Kelvinverse and how it's different just based on like the incident from Kelvin. And I am currently about 2 years away from the destruction of Vulcan, and they're having shenanigans on Discovery with Cybok, actually. So
that's really, really cool. That's like Kelvinverse, I don't know, cross Babysitters Club. They're all growing up as teenagers together. It's amazing. we'll have to find out from you at the end of the show where people can find some of your work, because that's a cool storyline. I love that. Mm-hmm. And how do you feel now that you're here in the hot seat? How's your confidence levels today going into the show?
I'm feeling okay. I mean, I've been told that if I don't get 20 points, that I'm fired from the show by Julian, but he fires me every day. So not anything different. You're so fine. I feel okay.
He's all bark, no bite, that Julian, I tell you what. Knowing nod from Giraffe. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Just get more points than him. That's all you need to do.
That might even be worse.
Yeah, or unlike Julian, make sure you listen to the whole question before you buzz in as well. I think that still stings him, poor guy. All right, well, we've got a very fun and challenging quiz for you today. Now, whenever I get two people on who have not met each other before, I like to look through your questionnaires and find what's a good cross-section of your Star Trek knowledge. Now, Deep Space Nine was your major cross-section. I would have loved it if it was the Kelvin timeline. So, Emcee, I have some people in mind who could be worth bringing you back for, regardless of today's outcome. But because you had a Deep Space Nine love, we are doing a quiz based in Deep Space Nine. However, we are doing today's quiz not on a season, not on a character, not on a type of episode. Today's quiz is the Dominion War Quiz.
Ooh.
Ooh. So how well-versed are you, Chrissie, on the Dominion War and Deep Space Nine?
Not as well as I should be, apparently.
We'll find out. And what about you, MC?
I think it's all right.
And what about you, MC?
I mean, we'll see how it goes.
Giraffe, you've had a little look over the questions. How do you rate them?
I would not have won that quiz, that's fair. I can't tell you that much.
All right. Well, let's rip that Band-Aid off then, shall we? So we're going to dive straight into the first round, which is a general knowledge round. Nine questions, hands on buzzers, let's go. Question one for a single point. Officially, how long did the actual Dominion War last?
2 seasons?
Emcee?
Sorry. I saw it said buzz. Sorry. I never That's pay okay. attention to giraffes, so.
I think I'm going to give that to you.
That is correct.
I have 2 years from 2373 to 2375, but 2 seasons is 2 years in Star Trek land. So congratulations. Well done. All right. So the second question, what was the name of the first Federation starship to be destroyed by Dominion forces?
Chrissie.
The Odyssey.
That is correct.
That's correct. The Galaxy-class starship under the command of Captain Keogh destroyed in Season 2 in the episode The Jem'Hadar. Third question. Good start, one all. What was the name of the Bajoran colony in the Gamma Quadrant that was destroyed by the Dominion? No one wants to have a guess. Do you need waiting music? That's something I haven't thought of. All right. No answer for that one. It was New Bajor.
Oh. Of course it was.
Of course it was. We find that out in the same episode, the Jem'Hadar. They show up on the station. They hand over the pad of everything that they've destroyed in the Gamma Quadrant. Dear. Still sticking on first for the Dominion. What was the name of the first Vorta that appeared on screen?
Emcee.
Eris.
That is correct.
Yes. Again, from the episode of the Jem'Hadar. Mm-hmm. We could have just made this a whole round based on that episode, it would seem. But yes, and she uses telekinetic powers in that episode, which we never saw again from the Vorta, and I'm kind of glad that that's the case. All right. So question five. The Dominion set up a massive sensor array in the Argolis cluster. That same cluster was also featured in a popular TNG season 5 episode. What episode am I referring to?
I'm going to do the waiting music.
Yes.
Chrissie.
The Inner Light? I know it's not that.
It is.
No. You don't take a guess, MC. There's a 1 in 25 chance I guess you could get it right.
Yeah, I don't know TNG episode name.
Oh, no! All right, that calls for one of these. It was in the episode.
I knew that episode name. So
did you?
Yeah.
It was in iBorg. So yeah. In fact, it showed up more than once in TNG. The Argolis cluster is referred to multiple times, usually by episodes that Rene Echevre had hands in the script for. But at the start of iBorg, they're scanning the cluster for potential sites, colonization sites, which led to the discovery of the Crash Borg scout ship that contained Hugh. The cluster is also featured in the Season 6 episode True Q. Well, featured, referenced. It's just a very popular cluster. Rather big cluster at that. All right. Yeah, exactly. Oh my God, you've never been to a party in the Argolis cluster? Missing out. All right, question six. In Season 6 of Deep Space Nine, what was the name given to the operation where the Federation attempted to retake Deep Space Nine?
Do, do, do. And we can both do a giraffe.
We should do a Star Trek one, you know? Like, I wonder what's the music in the turbo lift.
What do you think of my...
When we're humming the TNG theme, of course.
Data singing life forms in a jazz form like I did last week. Anyone want to make up a name that it might have been called?
Ooh, MC. Let's go.
I don't know. They're rather uncreative. So Operation Bajor?
Negative.
No, afraid not, afraid not. Chrissie, any guesses?
Take back Terraknor?
Negative.
No, it's actually very simple. It's Operation Return. That's all it was called. It's like... Someone went to... It's not even like a word a day calendar. Someone was like, well, we're going to return to Deep Space Nine, so I guess that's what we'll call it.
Should have been Operation Get My Baseball Back.
Way better.
Or his
way
son.
Better. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Which one's more important to you, Sisko?
Ouch, yeah.
Alrighty, so question 7 of 9, always worth a few points. We have 4 points up for grabs with question 7 of 9. Name the 4 alien races who were known to have signed non-aggression pacts with the Dominion.
Emcee.
Bajorans. Romulans.
Yeah. That's two. It's two more.
Andorians.
Not Andorians, I'm afraid. So we'll stop you there. That's 2 points, though, for Bajorans and Romulans, and we'll give Chrissie a shot at the other two.
Cardassians? And let's say Breen.
No. Negative. So they were allies. They didn't sign non-aggression pacts. It was the Tholians, as Giraffe does the Tholian scuttle with her hands there.
Okay.
And the Mirrodorn were also known to have signed non-aggression pacts with the Dominion.
Lots of Mirrodorn running around all the time. We just see everything about them.
So heavily featured, yes.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, so for the second last question, the Cardassian-Dominion alliance was formed partly due to the losses Cardassia had faced against which other species?
Emcee.
Klingons?
That is correct.
Well done, it was the Klingons. And last question, interesting to see if anyone knows this one. How many Wayoons were there in total?
Emcee?
9?
Negative.
No. Chrissie?
8?
That is correct.
It was 8. Yes, Wayoon 8 was the final one after the destruction of the cloning facility in the Alpha Quadrant.
I just remember it's so Wayoon 9's in the novels.
Yeah.
Oh, so shouldn't say this to a fan fiction writer, but we can't always count on the novels as being counted as canon.
Especially since they all got wiped out.
Indeed, yeah. Indeed. Yeah. All right, that is the end of round 1. An interesting start to the game. Mm-hmm. Giraffe, where have we landed score-wise?
Okay, first of all, I have to say, this counts by itself. I don't have to count. It's the future. It's the technology.
Here for you, babe. Here for you.
If you think that's cool, let me introduce you to Lotus 1-2-3.
Yeah.
Sorry, that was a really niche joke.
Yeah. There's an accountant laughing somewhere. Go Giraffe.
So, at the end of round 1, we have 5 points for Emcee and 2 points for Chrissie.
Wow. Ooh.
All right.
It's a solid start. It's a solid start. Not a huge lead on you there, Chrissie, so you've got plenty of chance to make up some ground in round 2. So let me ask you both, how good are you at episode titles when it comes to Deep Space Nine, Emcee?
Better than TNG.
And what about you, Chrissie?
I'm much better with TNG.
Well, that should make this interesting because this round is Name the Episode. where I have gone on to Paramount Plus, not sponsored, and taken episode blurbs from well-known episodes that relate to the Dominion War somehow. I'm going to read out those descriptions, and you need to buzz in if you know what the episode is. I've tried to... I do know that people don't remember Deep Space Nine episodes as well as maybe some of the other shows, so I've tried to pick the ones that I know are a little bit more popular, but we'll see how we go. All right, hands on buzzers. Round two is about to begin. First episode. Needing Romulan support to win the war, Sisko...
Ooh! Chrissie!
Please tell me, have you ever danced with the devil in the pale moonlight?
That is correct.
Well done, well done. And just, you know, props for, you know, the whole, like, little dramatic quote there. Love it. All right, second one. Sisko and his crew are stranded on a remote planet with a dying Vorta and a small group of Jem'Hadar.
Emcee.
The ship?
Negative.
Oh, no. The other one.
I know what one you're thinking of, but yeah, that was... It's almost a whole season before this episode, I think. Chrissie, do you know it?
That's what I was going to say. yeah. No idea. AR to whatever number it is. That's not right.
No, afraid not. It was Rocks and Shoals.
Yeah.
Oh, of course.
All right, then. So the third one. Preparing Earth for war with the Dominion, Sisko and Odo discover evidence of a Starfleet plot to seize control of planet Earth.
Emcee.
Paradise Lost?
That is correct.
Well done. Yes, very well done. One of my favorite two-parters, actually.
It's so good.
Yeah.
It is.
All right. Next one. With the wormhole closed, Sisko struggles to find a way to reestablish contact with the Bajoran prophets.
Emcee.
Images in the Sand?
That is correct.
That is indeed correct. You do know your DS9 episodes. All right, next one. Traumatized by the loss of his leg, Nog retreats to the holographic world of...
Emcee.
It's only a paper moon.
That is correct.
It is. Yeah.
I told you that with the more... The first one.
Exactly. Yeah. Only stuff that I mean. I know that quote, the pale moonlight one, because of Jack Nicholson as the Joker in the 1980s.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Which is where it came from. Like they thought it was an actual quote, but it's just from Batman.
Is it really?
Yes.
I thought it must have been. Wow. There
they
you go.
They thought it was like Shakespeare or something more. You know,
if I needed more reason for that to be my favorite Batman movie, I don't know what it is. But anyway,
it's matching, a Romulan plot, you know, like fake quotes.
There you go.
All right. Episode 6. One of Odo's people tricks Sisko and the crew into actions that could start a war in the Alpha Quadrant.
You need a music.
I really do. I'm going to work on that for next week's episode, or I'm going to edit it in.
There you go.
Unable to comply.
It was the adversary, the adversary, which was the season 3 finale. Mm-hmm. All right. Okay, the next one is going to require a bit of thinking power. 6 points up for grabs in this round's 7 of 9. Now, whoever buzzes in first gets the first shot at it. But as soon as you get one wrong, I will move over to your competitor. So the question is, name the 6 episodes from the Dominion War arc at the beginning of season 6. They don't have to be in order.
Emcee.
Time to Stand.
Yep.
Rocks and Shoals.
That's one of them too, yep.
Sons and Daughters.
That's one, yep.
Now I'm going to peter out.
That's all. Five, four, three. Oh, okay, that's, I mean...
Insufficient data.
So you do get 3 points, which is pretty sensational. So she pretty much got the first three, Chrissie. So there's three more in that arc. Do you know them?
No.
Nah. So, first of all, really, really well done on getting those three. Although you said them slightly out of order. You said the first, you said episode one, episode three, and then episode two. But I was impressed. I was like, oh, she's on the right path here. The three you did not get were Behind the Lines, Favor the Bold, and Sacrifice of Angels.
Yeah.
All right, two more episode descriptions to go. Quark leads a Ferengi mission to rescue his mother from the Dominion.
Chrissie.
The Magnificent Ferengi.
That is correct.
Well done, well done. And the last one. With the Cardassian resistance crushed, the Federation war against the Dominion reaches the prelude to one final showdown.
Emcee.
The Dogs of War?
That is correct.
Yes, the penultimate episode of the series. Well done. Wow. There we go. Someone's watched DS9 a few times, I think. You'd be surprised what comes to you sometimes, but congratulations. That was a good round, Emcee. But Giraffe, where did we land score-wise?
Okay, so for this round, we got 7 points for Emcee.
Well
and
done.
And 2 points for Chrissie.
Good work.
So total now, we are at 12 points for Emcee and 4 points for Chrissie.
So widening that lead. Tearing out in front.
I just had the first one in the pale moonlight to be.
That makes me feel better.
That's all I had.
You can, the lead is widened, but there is opportunity to make up ground both in round three and in the warp speed round. So it's not all done yet. Now, the third round is our Who Said It round. So, I am going to read a quote from the show, and there are two potential points for each quote. Now, you will get a point if you can tell me who said it. You'll get a bonus point if you can tell me which episode it's from as well. One or the other is fine if you only know one of the two, which is fine. So let's get ready. Hands on buzzers. I'll try my best impersonations, but I'm not very good at Deep Space Nine impersonations. And all it cost was the lives of one Romulan senator.
Emcee.
That's Garrick in the pale moonlight.
That is correct.
Yes, it was.
I suspect one that criminal was in there.
Yeah, and the self-respect of one Starfleet officer. I call that a bargain. All right. So, and the answer's actually wrong here. So on this on the screen, but I know what the right answer is. So,
yeah, right, because so, I do not.
Second quote. You believe the founders are gods, don't you?
Sounds like Jack Ransom.
I'm only hard when you make me hard. No, all right, five,
for... Oop!
Chrissie.
I'll say Odo.
Negative.
Right, yeah, not. So. MC, do you want to have a guess?
Bashir.
Negative.
No, it was Damar in the episode Tears of the Prophets. Yes. And Wayun looks at him and just goes, well, that's
because
different.
Because they are.
Founders are gods. Yeah. Duh.
Well, that explains the tone to that. Why it sounded like Jack Ransom.
Okay, next one. And Claire and
Buzzer. Yes. Thank you.
Thank you. These founders, Elam, they're very good. Next time.
Chrissie.
Oh, it's right there. Damn it.
An
Aubrentaine. An Aubrentaine.
It was.
To Garrick in. In the prison, that the name I can't remember.
So
that is correct.
You are correct. It was an Aubrentaine. MC, do you want to have a shot at naming the episode?
I can't remember the name of these episodes. Oh,
that's all good. It's from The Dyer's Cast, season 3. Again, another one of my favorite two-parters where they Garrick blows up his own shop and they launch that big attack on the Founder's homeworld. Super cool stuff.
I just taught Caesar Crossing the Rubicon in class the other day. And of course, the die is cast. I forgot that. That's where that comes from.
So it's not a Jack Nicholson quote. No.
Not unless he's played Caesar.
He may have.
He may have. He may have. All right, next quote. There's an old saying, fortune favors the bold. Well,
MC.
That is Sisko, and Fortune Favors the Bold. I don't think it's that one. I think it's the one before it.
It was Sisko, but that was, so that was not the episode. I'll give Chrissie, do you want to have a shot at the episode title?
No.
Oh, good.
Not Favor
good.
The Bold. Yep.
It was Sacrifice of Angels. Okay, fifth one. Constable, why are you talking to your beverage?
MC.
Worf. And that's in The Begotten.
That is correct.
Wow.
Nice.
That facial expression is well deserved, Giraffe, because I was surprised by that too.
Wow.
Well done. That's 2 points. Congratulations. All right, next one. There's no cure for the blight. The Dominion made sure of that. And I was so arrogant, I thought I could cure it in a week.
Chrissie.
That is Bashir.
That is correct.
In episode titles. No. It's something really straightforward too, like the plague, but it's not the plague. I don't know.
That's not the episode title. Do you want to have a quick shot at the episode title, MC?
The Quickening?
Yes.
That is correct.
It is The Quickening. So 1 point each.
It's so hard to not help people. I was going to, yes, it's that one with the plague.
I could describe the whole episode, but you know.
Yeah. Well, it's another one of those Bashir falls in love with his patient episodes.
That old trope. Such a horny doctor. Anyway.
It's the genetic modifications, you know.
Absolutely. Yeah. Okay. Next up, we have an audio question. You are going to hear 5 short snippets of distorted audio featuring B characters from Deep Space Nine. Once you hear all 4, buzz in and tell me who you think you heard.
Father, I helped Major Kira. and the others escape from the holding cells. The hippocat root is very versatile. It's used in certain medicines, diffractive optics, and even some beauty supplies. Here, feel how smooth my head is. Reports of my death have been exaggerated, but not by much. I rid myself of the prophets and shed a lifetime of hypocrisy.
Now you can buzz.
Emcee, who buzzed like
5 times. You had to wait till the end.
Sorry.
Oh, dear. Emcee, who did you think you heard?
It's Tora Zial.
Yes.
Moogie.
Yep. We'll let you have this moment. It's okay.
You gonna be okay there?
I think I've lost all of the other ones.
So, correct?
That is correct.
Zal and Moogie were the first two. Chrissie, who were the second two?
The last one was Kaiwin.
Kaiwin was there. So we're missing yeah. We're missing one. Do you know who the other one was?
The third one is that woman that was stuck on the ship that they thought they were talking to, but it turned out she'd been dead for a long time, and I don't remember her name.
Negative.
No, afraid not. It was okay. Cassidy Yates. It was Cassidy Yates.
Oh.
Yeah, when she was having right. morning sickness at the beginning of the What You Leave Behind. Yeah.
I have to say that they should redo DS9 with this voice for Kaiwin and Trekspert, like...
I mean, let's just listen to the Kaiwin one more time, shall we?
Because it's myself from the prophets and shed a lifetime of hypocrisy.
I love it.
They are my favorite. All right, we've got two more quotes and then we are warp speeding. All right, the second last quote. Captain, are you aware there's a Klingon on your bridge?
Chrissie.
I'm going to say that's Gul Dukat.
Correct.
I don't know the episode title. Let's say Way of the Warrior.
That is correct.
2 points!
Hey,
well done. Well done. That was good. All right. And last one. I have a dream. A dream that all people, human, Jem'Hadar,
Chrissie.
That is Quark. And that is in what You Leave Behind.
So it is Quark, yes.
That is correct.
It was not What You Leave Behind, though. Emcee, do you know what episode it was?
I don't know. The Emperor's New Cloak.
Negative.
No, it's way earlier than that. It was The Search.
Of course.
Yes. Everyone's standing together in peace around his Darbo tables. All right. That was an epic round. Wow. Giggling fits and all, where we got through it. Giraffe, how did they go?
So for that round, we have 6 points for Chrissie and 8 points for Emcee.
Not
which
bad,
brings
not bad.
The total to 20 points for Emcee and 10 points for Chrissie.
Wow.
Not
I gotta
fired. Get Geordie Bear here for the help.
But,
Geordie Bear's gonna help me here.
Bring Geordie Bear out. We've all got our... I can't believe I'm on a call with everyone that has... Everyone on this call owns a limited edition Geordie Bear, by the way, except for me. I just have a Captain Picard Christmas tree ornament. That's and a Wesley Crusher action figure still in its box. I'm literally
tougher
looking
for you to get to Chicago.
Yeah. I'm looking for something I can use as my good luck charm. I'll use my original series tricorder instead.
Oh, nice.
Beautiful.
I'll do like the, what does she do in Jadzia? She's like, you know, I love 23rd century design. Silver highlights, leather finish. All right, so let's go into warp. The warp speed round is 20 quickfire questions. Each question is worth a single point. You still have to buzz in to get it. I will not wait very long before hitting this button.
Unable to comply.
If I don't get an answer. So this can be make or break. Will Emcee hold on to that 10-point lead, or will Chrissie kick it into warp 9.9999999 without having to tell engineering, because this is the 25th century? So, hands on buzzers. Let's go into warp. Question one. Only one ship escaped the Second Battle of Chintoka without suffering the effects of the Breen's energy dampening weapons. What class of ship was it?
Chrissie.
Tenga.
Negative.
Afraid not. Emcee, do you know it?
Defiant.
Negative.
It was a Klingon bird of prey. Second question. Quark reported that a defector would bring down the minefield around the wormhole. What did he actually mean?
Emcee.
Oh. Just in time. Yeah, just in time.
A deflector.
That is correct.
Yes, he did mean a deflector.
I was about to ask if you misspoke. That's good.
All right, question three. Which Federation world was attacked by the Dominion, leaving a path open to conquer Vulcan?
Emcee.
Beta said.
That is correct.
Well done. Question four. Which member of DS9's crew was temporarily replaced by a changeling?
Chrissie.
Julian Bashir.
That is correct.
That is indeed correct. In season six, Bashir teams up with a think tank of genetically engineered people to determine the true intent behind the Dominion or proposed Dominion peace treaty. What was the name of the episode in which this occurred?
Chrissie.
Oh, I did the thing.
I did the thing. You. Oh,
damn it.
Five. Four. Three.
I thought you were going to ask if it was the jackpack. So.
Unable to comply.
Emcee, do you know the episode?
Statistical probabilities.
That is correct.
That is correct. Well done. Okay, next question. Who was responsible for preventing Dominion reinforcements from coming through the wormhole after the minefield was deactivated?
Chrissie.
The wormhole aliens / prophets.
That is correct.
Which is pretty much how I've written the answer here. Prophets or wormhole aliens. All right, question seven. Which third species teamed up with the Cardassians and the Dominion in the battle to take over the Alpha Quadrant?
Emcee.
The Breen.
That is correct.
It was indeed the Breen. During the Star Trek movies, we learned that who distinguished himself in the Romulan military, leading 12 major engagements against the Jem'Hadar, all of them successful?
Emcee.
Shinzon?
That is correct.
Well done. A morphogenic virus was introduced into the Great Link. Who engineered the virus?
Emcee.
Section 31?
That is correct.
That is indeed correct. Which Cardassian city did the Jem'Hadar destroy in response to the Cardassian rebellion?
Unable to comply.
Oh, Chrissie.
Go, Chrissie.
The capital? Cardassia City?
All of them. No.
Technically.
Here, see if you can get it from this set. That's for Lacarian City. No, you don't remember that bit? Lacarian City, when they're all hiding in... anyway. Cardassian comes down, shoots a Jem'Hadar and goes, that's for Lacarian City.
Okay. You know.
Damar eventually leaves his post as head of the Cardassian war effort to join the rebellion. Who takes his place?
Unable to comply.
His name was Legate Broker. What was the name of the Federation president at the start of the war?
Emcee.
Jarosh Enyo.
That is correct.
Well done. In the episode Paradise Lost, an enhanced Excelsior-class ship tries to prevent the Defiant from reaching Earth. What was the name of the ship?
Emcee.
The Lakota?
That is correct.
Well done. Which high-ranking Klingon was also temporarily replaced by a changeling?
Emcee.
Martok.
That is correct.
What is the name of the alien race who first mentions the Dominion to someone in the Alpha Quadrant?
Chrissie.
They want to buy Tulaberry wine. Canary? Not Canary, no.
Canaries?
That's a little bottle of Canar. Yeah. Canary, it's for the kids.
Negative.
Emcee?
Yeah.
Oh, I can't remember. I know the episode. Yeah, it is Tulaberry.
Yeah,
wine.
Me too.
Name's gone.
Unable to comply.
The Docei. Yeah, all right, we're getting to the tail end. Yeah. Getting to the tail end. Question 16.
Geordi, you're not helping.
Come on, Geordi. Pull your weight, buddy. Gold Dukat negotiated the deal for Cardassia to enter the Dominion. This meant toppling an existing ruling council on Cardassia. What was the name of that council?
Chrissie.
The Tapa.
That is correct.
Yes, the Tapa no. Council. All right. What was the final line we hear in the season 3 finale? Final words spoken.
Unable to comply.
You're too late. We're everywhere. All right, and question 18. What was the name of the fleet that was dispatched to halt the Dominion's advance in the Tyra system?
Unable to comply.
The 7th Fleet. And second last question. The instrument of the Dominion's surrender was called the Treaty of what?
Emcee.
The Treaty of Cardassia Prime?
Negative.
Nope. Chrissie, do you know it?
Treaty of Bajor?
That is correct.
That is correct. It was the Treaty of Bajor. Now, our final question, always my favorite, it's our impersonation. Which you both get to do. So, one at a time, I want to hear your best impersonation of the following.
So, this is a huge victory for the good guys.
Oh, is that the rest of it? All right.
Just that. Who would like to go first? Giraffe will judge who wins, by the way, out of this. You want to grab yourself a little whiskey glass or something? Like...
Yeah, we're done. Yeah. A tumbler full of water. All right.
All right, take it away, Chrissie.
All right. So, this was a victory for the good guys.
Come on.
I say the right. Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
Let me take a drink.
All right. Emcee, give us your best Cisco.
So, this is a huge victory for the good guys.
Good work, good work.
And I can live with this.
Yeah. You needed to channel, you know what I mean? You would just betrayed your entire everything that you believe to be good and true. You've murdered someone to bring someone into a war.
Yeah.
You know, just pretty much everything that you thought you were is gone.
The bitterness.
The bitterness. Yeah.
This is a great victory. A huge victory. Yeah.
Yeah.
Giraffe,
who impressed you the most?
I don't know. They were both very good. I'd say Chrissie.
Thank you.
Well, congratulations.
I was going to say, that's, talk about betrayal.
So that's one final point for Chrissie to end the game. Which brings us to the end of our quiz. Well, that was an exciting battle. But, Giraffe, we need to know, who is our ultimate Trekspert for today?
So you want the full result right now?
Oh, I want that full result, absolutely.
Okay. So, drum rolls. The Trekspert today is Emcee with 29 points.
Whoa! That's good. That's good.
That's two more points than me.
Fantastic. There you
go. It looks like you've still got a job at Strange New Pod on Monday. There we go.
Yeah, there you go.
And I can see here, Chrissie, you wound up on a total of 15. So not the lowest score we've ever had, which is good.
I'll take it.
And that's a 29. That's solid. That's solid. I think anything... Anything above 25 is a pretty high-scoring game for us, so congratulations. Give us your victory speech, Emcee. How does it feel to just be the ultimate Trekspert of all things the Dominion War?
I'd like to thank my ex-boyfriend who showed me Deep Space Nine for the first time. And
bless him.
Basically the only good thing that I got out of that relationship. And... honestly, I would very much like to come back and do a Kelvin trivia. And I would challenge Giraffe, but I know she won't do it after this.
So first of all, I think next time you're doing the Cisco impersonation, bring that ex-boyfriend bitterness into it. That'll be the perfect.
Oh, yeah.
And I think... Chrissie, I'm actually thinking Amy Nelson from the BQN. She loves the Kelvin verse, so we'll talk. We'll talk. Our people will talk to your people.
Okay.
Yeah. So well done. Well done. And Chrissie, your concession speech. Sorry, I can't talk today. Final words for your competitor.
I'm glad I'm not the only one that has that problem. Emcee, you have done well. I have to say, my military historian husband, who's also a expert on the Dominion War, would have whooped your butt, but I don't know. That sounds like
Whoa.
A really not feminist thing to say, so I shouldn't say that.
I love
I like some shade. Bring
absolutely,
shade.
Yeah. There has been far too much like lovey-doveyness from our competitors at the end of the games recently, and that's what I want. I want some shade. I want some sass. All done in a friendly way, though.
Yes, I'd say that with respect. I actually, you did great.
Well,
there were
you.
Times
you
that we both,
did,
well. You know, I was just right behind you, but there were a lot that I didn't know. So, go you.
Well done. Well done to both of you. Sometimes when I'm writing these things, I'm like, I'm being too hard. Like, this is going to be too hard. And I was thinking for some of this, I was like, oh, this is going to be a tough one. But turns out I have got some amazing Trekspert on today who absolutely nailed it. So congratulations to you both. Very impressed. Now, before we wrap up for today, we're going to do a quick whip around and see where all of our Trekspert listening or watching along at home can find you. I will start with the stunning Giraffe and her signed Geordie Bear. She's like, sorry, she was too busy stroking the bear. And she's like,
no, I thought you were asking, you were talking to Emcee. That's why I was like, oh, me, yes. So you can find me on all the socials at Spotted Giraffe. And on Thursday, I'm on Strange New Pod live. And I'll be at WonderCon next week on wow. Saturday for a Star Trek panel on archaeology and paleontology. Yay.
Yes, come say hi. Get along and check that out. Yeah, I wish I could see it. If it's being recorded or anything like that, hopefully we can watch it later. But fantastic. Yeah. And Chrissie, where can the Treksperts find you?
All right. Well, you can find me here on BQN on Infinite Diversity, where we talk about the new Trek as it comes out, and also on History with the Szylagis, which is a twice weekly little short history tidbits podcast that I do with my fellow historian partner, Jason. And I'm also happy to chat about all of this in the BQN Collective on Facebook. And I'm on Twitter at The Goddess Livia. That's TheGoddessLivia, where I tweet about Star Trek history and leftist politics.
Amazing. All of my favorite things. I will say, listeners, if you have not heard History with the Szylagis, it is a fun one to subscribe to and follow along. Each episode probably goes for no more than like 5 to 10 minutes, but everyone is just a fun little, interesting little essay about all kinds of history. In fact, the episode that got me hooked was when you did the history of Nintendo. That was my...
That was an interesting one. And Jay just dropped one on the history of Lego. Last week. So, yeah.
Very cool. Very cool.
Found out listening to that one. I did not know.
All right. And Emcee, our winner, our ultimate Trekspert, where can people find you?
So obviously you can find me on Strange New Pod on Thursday nights, which is at 9:30 Eastern. But I also have my own YouTube channel where I do daily headcanon minutes as well as video essays. And so that is Emcee Frodis. And that's also my name for all social media. I'm on Twitter, Instagram, all of those fun things. And for my fan fiction, I'm on Archive of Our Own as Emcee. And the story I mentioned at the beginning is called Better Daughter or Son.
Wow. I have not seen your fan fiction, but I am definitely going to go and look it up. And I would encourage our listeners to do the same, because that sounds cool. And yeah, I'm very excited to see where that goes. And also headcanon minutes. That's fun.
Daily minute long, ones. Each day is a different theme. So Trek is on Tuesdays, because of course it is. But I also have Marvelous Mondays, Slayer Saturdays, and Free for All Fridays. So
yes, I have caught some of your Buffy ones before. And another, yeah, you're after my heart here, Emcee. That's amazing. Well, okay, so that is it for today. And of course, as always, listeners, viewers, there is some fabulous content to sink into from across all three of my guests today, whether it be History with the Szylagis, Strange New Pod, Headcanon Minutes. There's some really fun stuff there. So get along and find them out. Do yourself a favor. To wrap things up from me, though, if you were absolutely banging your head against the wall on the off occasion that one of our Trekspert's today did not know an answer to one of the questions and you think you can do better, well, why not put your latinum where your mouth is? Register to be a contestant by heading over to trekspertsquiz.com and filling out the form on our website. Make sure you follow us on Instagram, Twitter, or Facebook by searching for Trekspert's Quiz. You can also email us directly, TrekspertsQuiz@gmail.com. We welcome all your feedback, quiz ideas, or just to say hello. Don't forget to check out the other amazing shows on the BQN Podcast Network, such as All Good Things, Galaxy Class, History with the Szylagis, Infinite Diversity, Mickey's Marvels, Sasswatch, What's the Tea Bev, and my new show on YouTube, The Bargain Bin Gamer, spelled G-A-Y-M-E-R. You can find any or all of these by searching for the BQN Master Feed wherever you get your podcasts from. Don't forget, you can also interact with all the BQN hosts and listeners over on our BQN Collective Facebook page. And that is it for today. Remember, until next time, no matter what you do and no matter where you go, make sure you go boldly. Peace out, live long, and prosper, everyone. Woo!
The space station. That's right. Major Kira, from the space station. What brings you here?
I do, Vedic Gwyn.
Good for you, Vedic Baran. After working so hard, you deserve a little recreation. How long will you be with us, Major?
I'm not sure.
Feel free to stay as many days as you like. Even a week if necessary.
Rid myself of the prophets and shed a lifetime of hypocrisy.
I've never seen you look so radiant.
I feel like a young woman waiting for my lover to sweep me away.
Do you give yourself willingly to the Barrettes?
With all my heart.
Then call to them.
Bring me the book.